episode, we are starting our organic t-shirt showreel with this collusion t-shirt, and this is part of ASOS's responsible edit. It's a crew neck, short sleeves, logo printed on the chest. It's a regular fit, true to size, and it is unisex. Now, a little bit about the brand. This is a new brand from the coming of age generation that refuses to compromise on principle or style. Collusion also does denim, knitwear, clothes, and loads more. This is machine washable according to instructions. And about the clothes itself, about me, it says I am soft, breathable, made from organic cotton, grow with less water, no pesticides. It's a win-win in improving the environment for both wildlife and cotton farmers. Now, moving on to t-shirt number two. Now, about this t-shirt, soft jersey. I don't know why they're calling them jerseys, because it's a t-shirt. Anyway, soft jersey made with organic cotton, grows with less water and no pesticides. Basically, all of them say this. Maine, 100% cotton, organic cotton. So this t-shirt is by G-Star, part of our responsible edit on ASOS. It's actually a pack of two. You get for £30 two t-shirts, which means one is £15. I think that's how the math works in this industry. I don't know, but yeah, crew neck, short sleeves, plain design, slim fit, narrow cut sleeve and chest. So The brand is actually a denim pioneer. G-Star is famed for their work with raw denim jeans, utilizing innovative techniques to create new styles and cuts. So the G-Star range now includes everything from t-shirts to coats, all in their signature utilitarian style. God knows. Sorry. Okay, let me try. All in their signature utilitarian style. I've learned a new word today. Anyway, I've got this in actually a small, it's a men's t-shirt, but after all, it is a white organic t-shirt. Moving on to t-shirt number three, and this t-shirt is by Rayburn. I think that's how you pronounce it. Again, part of our responsible edit, ASOS says. It is 100% organic cotton. I want to assume the 100% is pertaining to the fact that it is 100% organic, not that it is 100% cotton. So they focus on sustainability. Rayburn creates distinctive functional clothes from recycled materials by reworking surplus fabrics into new designs. The label's military-inspired pieces don't just look good, they do good too. Scro, its latest eco-conscious collection in our Rayburn at ASOS edition, stocked with organic cotton t-shirts, trousers, sweatshirts, as well as recycled joggers, jackets and accessories. So this is apparently their thing. They focus on recycling, upscaling, reworking material, basically. Last but not least is this crew neck. Once again, sleeveless style, padded shoulder, regular fit, true to size, part of our responsible edit according to ASOS. Oh, ooh, 95% organic cotton and then 5% elastin. That is a lot of information. I mean, it's transparent. About the brand, so this is by Weekday. With Scandi roots and a street style vibe, converted laid back, minimal look. Founded in 2002, the Swedish brand draws inspiration from art, pop and youth culture to create its super fresh collection. Scroll our Weekday at ASOS edition for relaxed basics such as t-shirts, dresses, jackets and staple denim pieces, all filtered by swimwear, lingerie, accessories to discover everything from bikini separates to soft cup bras to paired back up playful jewelry and sunglasses. Wow, okay, everything, as well as organic cotton, sustainable, they're in there too. I am by no means in the business of bashing brands. But what I am trying to do is to educate you guys, to share with you my findings, and learn with me too, because I'm also learning. You know, you can teach me one or two things too. I just want to give you the information so you know what is going on out there. So I do all of this to say, beware of greenwashing. Greenwashing. If you haven't heard that term before, greenwashing is basically, as it sounds, painting, washing what wouldn't otherwise be as though it is sustainable, as though it is conscious of our environment. And I mentioned this previously in my videos where I said, you know, a lot of these big brands are offering you sustainably resourced clothes because that is what is in right now. And so, but then the question is, are they really though, as mega as they are, as abundant as options are they really? The truth is, any company can afford to offer you organic materials, recycled materials, if they can afford to do so, if they can profit from it. So for you and I, just because a company is offering that, it does not mean that it is sustainable. They cannot keep giving us that level of products without something running out or somebody, you know, falling short of something, either wage inequality or just, you know, unhealthy environments that they're working in, squeezed margins, or simply just us using up so much material that we are taking too much from our planet. We've kind of been offered a rebranding of our problem, which is potentially we are shopping too much. We don't need to buy it just because it's organic. We still have to adhere to the basics, you know, that will keep us healthy, keep our planet healthy, and that's a win-win. So what actually matters and what is sustainable? In my opinion, I honestly think that quality over quantity is probably the number one of this whole journey. When you have quality, you will have clothes that last longer. You will have clothes that you can do more with. And because they last longer, you have more chances of being able to upscale them, upcycle them, so that you can maybe turn them into something else or use them in other pieces if that particular style is no longer desirable to you, or it rips, or it needs amending, whatever. I will say, when I was going up the t-shirts, so obviously I started with the cheapest, which was £6, and then the others were two for £30, and then the other was £79. This is £20. You definitely do feel the difference in quality as the price goes up. The £79 t-shirt was really soft and of course a lot thicker. Now, do you need to spend £79? No, you really do not. And this nicely leads me to my second point of what is truly sustainable, and that is, look after what you have. When you get something, get it with the intention to keep it for the long term. And part of keeping it is looking after it. So, you know, read the care label and try to stick to that so that the item is as good as though it is new and it lasts for longer. This nicely leads me to my third point, which is a lot of this has to do with our mindset. We have a lot of power. And to be honest, brands will sell us what we think we want. Yes, there's marketing. Yes, there's ads. But at the end of the day, it's your mindset. If you are ready to just be led or influenced because this is what's in, or this is what's being advertised, then you're going to buy everything under the sun that is advertised in each season. But if you educate your mind that you only buy what you need when you need it, and before you even opt for buying something new, you're going to explore everything else, such as buying secondhand, looking at what you already have to see if you can tailor it, or buying on Depop, charity shops. And those are really cool ways, and you get really cool and unique things that are also really good quality. So part of changing your mindset is basically be willing to not overbuy. Do not feel the need to overbuy, you know, and also have a mindset that's willing to change. Lastly, this is something I've done videos about in the past, and I am actually going to do another video on, which is basically related to spring. And that is shopping smart. And that means Essentially, when you buy something, just don't buy with the one occasion in mind. Buy with the future in mind. Future in terms of future occasions you can wear it. Future in terms of you don't want to keep buying, and therefore we want to look after our planet so we are not over consuming. So when you're buying a skirt, a dress, a cami, you know, a statement piece, whatever it may be, where else can you wear it other than what you are currently buying it for? And before you click that checkout button, can you get it secondhand somewhere? Can you find it secondhand somewhere equally as good as new, or, you know, on a trusted platform? Think about those things, because that is definitely all part of shopping smart. Now, I really hope you enjoyed this video. And if you have any questions or any insights or things that you found out that you've been curious about, definitely feel free to comment it all below. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.